Hi, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to do one of those videos where I just talk a little bit of the pens in my collection. Today the theme of this video is my blue marbled pens. And I have six pens that fit into this category as far as I see it. There are other pens with blue color, but I don't think they really fit in this kind of situation. But maybe one day I'll make just a blue pen, every blue pen video. So let's take a look at these pens. These are quite different pens, six pens from three different brands. Sorry, four different brands. And so let's go for the first one. This is a pen I already reviewed here, and it is a Chinese pen. It is a Vingsung 626, which is a pen that resembles a Schiffer Balance. It has the dot here, which is not white, it's golden color dot, the same kind of clip to clip bands and to cap bands, and it's very similar. The cap unscrews and we have this nib, this two-toned nib, which looks nice. Vingsung, it's an F nib and it has a heart-shaped breather hole, which I find quite interesting. And it is a cartridge converter pen. And let's just cap the pen and give you, put this in focus, just an overview of the depth of this marble blue. And now we have here another one. It is a big pen. It is a Conklin All-American blue. It was sent by Appleboom for review, and there is the All American there, written, engraved on the barrel. This pen has just something that is quite weird in my opinion, which is the engraving on the barrel is the right way like this, but the clip is the wrong way, is upside down. But when you post it, it comes the right way, so I don't know. But when I see it closed, it makes me, it's strange. This is a pen that has also a steel nib, like the Chinese one. It has a breather hole in the shape of a crescent moon. It is also a two-tone nib, and is also a cartridge converter pen. Both these pens are still in production. This is a very beautiful and attractive material, a very beautiful resin in my opinion also, and let me focus here for you to see the kind of depth of this material. And now we will move into a Kaweco Sport, and this is the Kaweco Art Sport Generation 1. The name of this pen is Blues, and it is not, I was hesitating about putting this pen in this video because it's not really a marbled pen, it is more a swirly pen. It is quite transparent with these white swirls. It's beautiful, also a steel nib. This one is just one color nib, and it is also a cartridge pen. It can also take the short Kaweco pens, Kaweco converters, sorry. And here you have the material, the finish of it. And you can see how this has really doesn't have many, a lot of color depth, but has this nice swirl. And one thing that is curious, because this is transparent, you can see the barrel swirls below the beneath the swirls of the cap, and somewhere here is engraved Kaweco art sport there. Then this pen is no longer in production. Then we go to the Caveco Art Sport Generation 2, and this version is called Lapis, and it has a very different material than that one, but it is a very similar pen. It has gold color trim, so it has a gold colored nib, gold plated nib, also a cartridge converter pen. And let me just show you how the material looks under the light. It has quite different parts. This one has more black and a more plain blue, but when you start rolling it, you can see here much more depth, very interesting color shading in my opinion. And then let's move on to this one. This is a Parker Centennial Dufold Blue Marbled. It has this plain cap from the older style Centennial Dufold, a double cap band, a double band on the end of the barrel, and also a double band on the section. It is a cartridge converter pen, and this is not in production anymore. It has a gold nib, a two-tone gold nib with the arrow there, and it has this pattern. And let me show you, it is quite different from the other ones. I think it is almost between the swirls and the other marbled one. I think this is a dark shade of blue, which is quite beautiful. And then we'll go on to a Parker Dufold also, but this is shorter. This is an international Dufold, and it is from a newer version that has two cap bands and a different medallion on top of the cap. It has a medallion actually, the other one doesn't have, and it has a single band here and also a single band there. It is also a cartridge converter pen, and it also has a two-tone gold nib with the arrow, but the arrow on the nib has the Dufold banner on top of it. And I will just show you the kind of material. This is all artificial light, so I hope you can see it well. This has not so much depth as the other Parker Dufold, but it is nice. Now I'll do something that will frighten some viewers that don't like to see the pens scratched, but I will take some care with it, but I'll be careful. But I want to show you all at the same time, and these are the variations. So these two blues are quite similar, and similar also to that one. This one is darker, this one is darker with white shading, and this is definitely different. So this is quite interesting in my opinion. And because I know that you like it, I'll just do a quick writing sample for you to see how the pens perform, because they are quite different and you may be interested. The ink that is in every one of these pens is the Montblanc Meisterstück Blue Hour Twilight Blue. It is a beautiful shade of blue that I like, and I'll just show you how these pens write. And let's start with the Conklin. This pen will be reviewed by the date when I'm publishing this. There is no review published yet, and this is the Conklin All American Blue with that ink that I showed you, and the nib, just let me check, is a medium nib. This pen has been washed recently, so sometimes the ink is a little watery still. Now, let's go for the Vingsung. And this is the Ving Sung 626 with a fine nib. And this is good pen with a very wet and somehow soft nib. Then we go to a medium Caveco nib, an older one that performs quite wet. And this is the Caveco Art Sport Blues with an M nib. And you can see the ink seems much darker here because of the wetness of the nib. And because we are into Cavecos, let's go to the Caveco Art Sport Lapis. And this is an F nib. Although it is narrower, it is even drier. So there is a big difference between that M and the F. Although we have to understand that these are different generations of nibs, so there are differences between them. Then we have the Parker International Duofold Lapis also with an F nib. Yes. The Parker nibs write really well. I like them a lot. And finally, we have the Parker Centennial Duofold. It skipped there, but I think it was my fault. Duofold, and this one has an M nib, I believe. Yes. With an M nib. All of these pens are with this ink, as I told you. So, this is all for today. Let me put here the blue pens. I hope this was interesting, and I hope this can give you some ideas of pens that you maybe want to look for if you are into this kind of finish and resin. So, this is all for today. Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and keep coming back for more videos. See you next time. Bye.